And another thing you did is, like you mentioned this, you trusted a lot on the youth. You brought in Zwala, Len, Udanta, all these guys came through, Shankar, all of them came through. So was that like something that you, it's ingrained in you, or was it a plan from the club to help bring out young players up?
Yeah, I mean, when I first met the club, and we think back, the club had sat down with the owners and they said, listen, there's two options here. We can go and spend like everybody else spends and get the best players in India, all the current national team players, and pay them 50, 60, 70 lakhs a year. Or we can get young players and we can develop them through good coaching and we'll get them into the team and we'll make a good club for the future. And obviously, the club chose the second option. They wanted a young side. They wanted something that could get players into the national team. And that was the way we went. So, me coming through a good youth system at Man United that set standards regards your character and how you apply yourself was just kind of like implementing that, really. Never afraid to play the young players. I remember in the league, they used to have a rule there. I think it was under 21 player had to start, one had to be on the bench, and week in, week out, other clubs were starting 21-year-olds, 19-year-olds, and bringing them off after 15 minutes, which I thought was disgusting. And there's many managers guilty of that if you look back in there, just destroying young players, putting them on because they have to put them on, but then bringing them off and breaking the rules. I thought was terrible. We never did that. We never, I didn't even have to think. I don't think ever did we think, oh shit. We haven't got an under 21 on the bench, or we haven't got an under 21 or whatever age it was in the starting 11, because we had loads of them, and they were all good enough because they trained properly, and you get lots of improvement out of them. Yes, they make some mistakes. That's part and parcel of learning. But we were very clever. Pradyum, myself, Mandar, always looking at Tata Academy, always looking at the AIFF Academy and seeing what the next ones were coming through. We signed Nishu. We signed Daniel and we signed Zwala all together at the same time after playing the AIFF under 19s. We signed Adanta from the Tata Academy after playing them and seeing him. And we just looked for attributes that we could improve. And that's what we used to bring into the football club and then just train them correctly and get them ready. And we enjoyed doing it. And there's nothing better from a coach, from all the coaching staff, from all the people at the club that bringing a player in that's never played in the professional league, training him for 3 months, 6 months, and then him making his debut and being an important part of the club. And that's why the club have also, always gone from strength to strength, because we've always had an array of young players that if coached correctly, can develop and get into the side.
And how difficult was that rebuilding process also? Because the first year you lost Minyonger, second year you lost Sean Rooney and a couple of others. And this keeps happening, but you just keep adding new players in.
I was always on the, again, whether it's an Alex Ferguson thing or what, you never stand still. You always improve. The players that left only left because we decided they'd leave. They all wanted to stay. Johnny Mononga had a good year. We won the league. And everybody thought it was nailed on, he'd get a new contract. But I sat him down and said, listen, you've done great, but you're 34, 35, and we need to improve. And we needed to get a footballer that was as good as Johnny, but then we needed a footballer that was better at defending because the levels were already always going up. And that's why we always used to cut five, six, seven, eight players a season and just basically upgrade them. We would go from the first year of the I League, we would look at the league and say, right, we want to improve. Who have we played against? Who's a good player? We noticed Eugene at Shillong. We noticed Fanai, the left back, 20 at Shillong. We'd noticed Alwyn George at Dempo or people like that. And we thought we can get these in and they're good players and then we can improve them with our training and keep growing and keep improving. And that was why we had, a turnover of players, but we always kept our nucleus, our core, and just tried to upgrade year on year. Sean Rooney was getting a little bit, I don't know, a little bit homesick. He could see he was starting to drop his standards with his application. So it was time to upgrade him. We see Kim, we played against him at, I think, Randajid United or whatever it was. He was a handful. He was the only centre forward in the league that, in my opinion, gave John Johnson and Kurt Susanoo a bit of a hard time. So he was the one that we replaced as our Asian. And it was just, recruitment from doing our homework correctly by watching games, by playing against teams, by looking at characters and just kept improving the team.
So you just mentioned Eugene. Now, the story of you signing Udanta after watching him play and then calling Mandar and saying sign him is quite well told. What is the story behind signing Eugene? Because under you, he became a 1 crore player, a national team player, one of the best in the recent years that you've seen in football. Unfortunate with injuries since, but nevertheless, what did you see in him?
Well, we played against him for Shillong. I noticed him taking set pieces. He was two-footed. At the time, he kicked one of our players. And I think I shouted on to him to try and warn him. And that stuck in my mind. Thought he's a little bit tough as well. You know, he's not just a quiet boy. He can put his foot in. I can't remember who he kicked. It was one of our players. And he was athletic. And I knew that if we brought him into our systems, we could improve him again. Because he had the attributes, which is what we always kind of look for. And we knew with our systems and our fitness and our nutrition and our family club, if you like, with the way everyone clicks together, that we could improve him and get him ready. And he came in, he was magnificent for us. Turned out for me to be one of the best midfielders in the country because he had everything. Like as mentioned, his pace, his balance, two-footed, can tackle as well if need be, as long as you keep on top of him. And I knew he could be something, and he was. And he's just like I mentioned before, since I've left, since training's changed, since, you know, attention to detail maybe has changed, then his fitness has dropped. And Eugene's one of them players that you need to get him fit first. You know, he loses his fitness very quickly. You know, his cardiovascular work, he doesn't quite like it too much. He has a bit of a tendency to not push himself, but you have to find ways of making him push himself to get himself super fit. And when he's super fit, he's one of the best. But like I've mentioned, you know, the ISL clubs he's been to, he went to Pune with coaches, maybe just coming there for quick fixes, not attention to detail, that aren't thinking of longevity. I think he had a spell at, was it maybe Mumbai? I can't remember. Definitely Pune, I remember that one. Obviously, he's been at ATK recently, back to Bangalore this year. You know, he got a minor setback at ATK where he started to get fit and he was doing all right, but then he injured his knee 4 months out. And then again, you've got to get the right coaches and the right tools into him to get him super fit. And once he is, he's one of the best.